Cigarettes after sex there with Nothing's Gonna Hurt You Baby. Oh fucking hell, I must stop doing that. I'm trying to wear a crash helmet so as to not incur any further concussions. Cigarettes after sex, what a great name for a band. They used to be called Cigarettes During Sex, but it just didn't work. Because really, when you are in the moment, you have to be in the moment, you have to be there. No distractions, not adding up the electricity bill, the kilowatt units per hour thing in your head, or, you don't want to be, what else could you be doing? You could be, do not watch TV, do not read a book, don't be cutting your toenails, don't do the ironing, and above all, do not walk the dog. Okay. I'm going to read you two poems today from the world's greatest poetry magazine, PB Mag, the Poetry Bus magazine, PB. This is PB7. The first poem is by Claire McCotta called Oniric Tattoo. Oniric, I didn't know what oniric meant. It means dream, to do with dreams, dreamlike. There's another two or three words in here that I wasn't familiar with. Selenic, which is a lovely word. It's relating to the moon. I love new words. I love finding new words, looking them up. And some of you might know these, like sard means reddish brown. I didn't know that. Arapaho, I did kind of know. I knew vaguely it would be some kind of Native American Indian, but it's the American Indian people of the Plains region. Claire McCotta is a fine poet, published here, there and everywhere. Her finest hour, of course, would have been in PB7. Everything's back to front. She has a collection with Salmon. She has another one due in 2023. Should we all live that long? And she won the British Haiku Award in 2017. I am the president of PAH, Poets Against Haiku, because have you read them? Okay. Blah, 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 blah. Blah, something. Three lines of fuck all, usually. But occasionally they're good because we have published some haiku. What is the plural of haiku? Haiku. Say no more. Claire McCotta, Oniric Tattoo. Descended from the north, your hidden face is a raven's dying wing. Is this still fucking recording? It is. I've done this three times now, and the last two times, it didn't record. Claire McCotta, Oniric Tattoo. Descended from the north, your hidden face is a raven's dying wing. What memory shapes your mouth on my forehead as its cavernous embers transfigure? Thou art dust, and unto dust thou shalt return. In that same place a violin's blood breaks the skin on a deer-shedding moon. Your selenic trail, a lariat of discarded antlers, comes back to me when a sard wolf is full on the horizon. This time, the last, your head rises to reveal bone needles and charcoal in your lips, my brow seared with an Arapaho kiss. I think that's amazing. The second poem is by Gerard Smith, who is very well known in Ireland, very widely published, and editor of or poetry editor of the Irish Times. This one is called In Her Paris Shawl. In her Paris shawl, she walks with me through the rain-soaked, sun-scorched middle of the week. She has come the way of the wild geese to be with me where May and June are well defined, and every museum is a museum of desires. Back to where we came in the least of our days, that summer we turned and missed Baudelaire's christening church, but saw his early grave. Like Louis Armstrong in his wonderful world, we are lost in too much of everything good. The honey locust appearing like a third day miracle, and in the Louvre, young Rembrandt's eyes still glistening. Gone are the barricades and gone the man who played with sweet finesse his twangling instrument. Six sombre strings sounding wistful, one breaking like a wishbone. So that is that. I hope you're all well. I hope you're enjoying this dull Sunday. Aren't Sundays always dull? Every day is like Sunday. Every day is like Sunday. I'm going to leave you with a tune by The Specials called Do Nothing. The Specials formed by Toothless Wonder Jerry Dammers, who went on to also found the Rubettes and an ABBA tribute band. The lead singer, of course, was Terry Hall, Po-faced Terry Hall, and he had a very famous sister, of course, Jerry Hall, and a third sibling who was very, very widely travelled, and he was called Long Hall. So that's it. I can do no more for you, really. Here is The Specials with Do Nothing. But whatever you do, do something! Yourself.
Yeah.